Question number 11, Nikki Kaye.
Mr. Speaker, question to the Minister
Order.
Of Internal
I've
Affairs.
Called Nikki Kaye.
What announcements has he made regarding the iGov scheme and increasing online access to government services?
Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Nathan Kaye.
Last week, the Electronic Identity Verification Bill was introduced to Parliament, which will allow the iGov Identity Verification Service to be used widely across government and by the private sector. The iGov Logon and Identity Verification Services provide an easy and secure way of accessing government services online and proving identity. They have great potential to deliver better, more secure and cost-effective online services to the public. I also announced last week an agreement that's been signed between Internal Affairs and New Zealand Post to develop and promote these services, which will help make these services much more accessible to the public.
Nikki Kaye.
Mr. Speaker, supplementary question. What kind of services can the iGov logon and verification services be used for?
The Honourable Nathan Kaye.
Mr. Speaker, currently around 30 services are available, such as booking swimming lessons via the Wellington City Council or ordering a birth certificate through Internal Affairs, and there are more than 320,000 iGov logons in use. This is far more convenient for the public because they only have to remember one logon detail rather than a whole bunch and don't have to queue in line with different forms of ID. With New Zealand Post coming on board and ultra-fast broadband rolling out across the country, we expect more and more services to become available in the future.
Question number 12, the Honourable Rick Marker.
Mr. Speaker, my question...